This is part one of completing the square. On this video, we learn how to add a constant or a variable term, as in numbers 6 and 7, to a binomial to make a perfect square trinomial, and then write that perfect square trinomial in factored form. We do the following problems. I'm going to show you how to complete the square in this video to write perfect square trinomials. So first of all, let me show you two perfect square trinomials. X squared plus 6x plus 9 is called a perfect square trinomial because it factors to x plus 3 squared. So it's a perfect square of x plus 3. Another one is x squared minus 10x plus 25 because that factors to x minus 5 squared. Our goal here will be to take something that is not yet a perfect square trinomial. So let's say we had x squared minus 8x, and we're going to figure out what would have to be added to that to make it a perfect square trinomial, which means you're going to be able to write it as a binomial squared. All right, so that's our goal. So here's the key. Notice in this first one, x squared plus 6x plus 9, that if I look at the coefficient of x, which really is a plus 6, half of that, the plus 3, is what gets added to x inside the parentheses. So half of that, half of 6, is 3. Then notice the last term, 9, is 3 squared. See how if I just do 3 squared here, I end up with a 9. Okay, so check it out how it works on this second one. I've got minus 10x, and I end up with minus 5 inside the parentheses, right? X minus 5, that's half of that coefficient of x, and then 5 squared is what gets added over here. So if I do 5 squared, notice I end up with plus 25. Now, both cases, the last term is going to be positive, because when you square a real number, you're going to get a positive. So we always end up with a plus at the end. And in both of these cases, I do just have an x squared. It will be different if it was a 5x squared. But this will be true anytime it's just an x squared or a y squared, etc. So let's see if we could use that technique on this problem. X squared plus 8x plus something, what will that have to be? Well, if this is an x squared, this will have to be an x. So the first term will be the x squared. If this is a minus, that will be minus. And then the key is you take half of the coefficient. You've got negative 8, so basically you're just taking half of 8, okay, which is 4. Or you could think of a half of negative 8, why I'm writing minus 4. In any case, if there's a minus sign here, there'll still be a minus sign here. To get this number up here, you're just going to do 4 squared. And there you go. Plus 16 is what you have to add to complete the square. So once you do half of 8, which is 4, then 4 squared is 16. Now, I usually don't even write this out on the side. It's pretty simple to do. You write x, the minus sign, you just put half the number there, and then go 4 squared, and then go up here and write down what you would have to add, which is the 16. So let's try that on another problem. All right, so we have this binomial, x squared minus 12x, which is not a perfect square. And the question is, what can we add to it to make it a perfect square? And then we're going to write it in factored form. So what I do is I go down here and I say, all right, my goal is to write it as something squared. And I have to figure out what's going to be added here. So we start out with the x, because that will give you the x squared, the minus. And then half of 12 is 6. So this will be x minus 6. So notice I'm figuring out the factored form first, and then it's easy to figure out what you'd have to add. Just 6 squared is 36. And there you go. So I've now realized that 36 is what I add to make this a perfect square trinomial, and then the factored form would be x minus 6 squared. Let's do another one. Alright, here's the next problem. I have x squared plus 5x, so the question is, what are we going to add to that to make it a perfect square? So we know, I want to write it as something squared. So we start out with the x plus. Now, a lot of people get confused right here. They think, uh-oh, what's half of that? Well, if it's an odd number, you just write it as a fraction, 5 over 2. That's half of 5 is 5 over 2, right? If it's an even number, like 6, of course, 6 over 2 would be 3, and you would just write the number 3. So now, what is it that has to be added? 5 halves squared. So that's 5 squared over 2 squared, right? If you need to write it out, go ahead. 5 halves times 5 halves. So 25 fourths is what needs to be added to make that a perfect square trinomial. Okay, let's see if you could do this one on your own. X squared minus 9x. Right, so you want to put the video on pause and figure out what gets added and then write the answer as a perfect square. Okay, so I'm going to add something, right? Not sure what. I want to write this as something squared. Again, it's just going to be x minus. And what's half of 9? 9 halves. Don't write it as a mixed number. That makes it more complicated. Trust me. So just write it as 9 halves. And so what gets added up here? 9 halves times 9 halves? 81 fourths. All right, let's do another one. A lot of people have trouble with this one. X squared minus x. Okay, so again, we have to figure out what we're going to add. I'm just putting plus a blank. We have to come down here. Again, it's going to be x minus, and here's the trick. What's going to go there? Well, what you have to do is look at the coefficient of x, which is 1. You don't see it. It's invisible, right? But this could be thought of as a 1. So what's half of 1? A lot of people want to put x over 2, but it's only half of the coefficient. So it's x minus 1 half. So be really careful if you don't see a 1. Remember, 1 is the invisible coefficient. And then when I square 1 half, you get to add 1 fourth. So now you can take that off, right? There it is. X squared minus x plus 1 fourth. That's now a perfect square trinomial. And I'm writing that as x minus 1 half squared. Here's another one for you to try. X squared plus bx. That's not a 6, it's the letter b. Well, how would we do that one? If you want to try on your own first, put it on pause. Okay, so we need to figure out what's going to go in the parentheses here. So again, this is going to be an x and a plus, and I have to do half of the coefficient. Okay, the coefficient is b. All right, how do we write half of b? If you're not sure, write it over here. What's half of b? It's just going to be b over 2. Just like if it was 5, it would be 5 over 2. So this will be b over 2. And then squaring that's what it's going to go up on the blank here, b squared over 4. And there you go. Here's one more for you to try. X squared minus b over ax. See if you could figure that one out. Did you put the video on pause and try it on your own? All right, here we go. It's going to be an x. It's going to be a minus. Now we have to do half of b over a. All right. If you can't do that in your head, write it over here. What's 1 half of b over a? It's b over 2a. So then what would go up on the blank? Square the numerator and square the denominator. We're going to have b squared over 4a squared. All right, so hopefully you are getting really good at completing the square and writing it in the factored form as a perfect square.